Hi guys, this is Alex Panasenko, Senior Product Manager here at COTI. I'm happy to do another tutorial or video when we are going to show you the new Explorer 2.0 interface. We're going to elaborate on the new enhancements that we introduced today to our COTI Explorer. And, you know, let's jump into it. All right, so first of all, we can see that COTI Explorer UI has totally changed. Basically, now we have stats cards that show us this updated COTI price, the TVL of our treasury, and the average confirmation time of the trust chain. Keep in mind, this is a development environment, so the stats might not be aligned. I think the first main improvement that you guys can see is basically that we designed the latest transactions table. And now you can see that we have different transactions with different new tokens coming in into this view. So as you are probably aware, with the release of COTI's CMD, we are able to generate and mint new tokens on the trust chain. And in addition, we'll be able to host new assets from different networks. All right, so now you can see the different transactions are made on the trust chain, right? So we have some generate transaction, mint transaction, transfer transactions with different tokens. And let me show you how we can actually generate a new token and use it. All right, so let me just jump into my Viper wallet and go to my tokens, and let's create a new token, and let's call this token green, right? And let's give it a symbol, GGGG. All right, and let's say the total supply for this token will be 10 million in total. All right, so GG already is in use. Let's use, okay, so now we have LLL. Okay, so let's generate this token and see what happens on the Explorer side. Now we have the transaction hash, and let's jump to our Explorer 2.0. Okay, so you can see here's our transaction, right? The generate transaction of the LLLL token, right? The amount is zero because basically we haven't minted any tokens yet. So this, when this transaction is completed and confirmed, now we will be able to mint the new tokens. So let's jump in and mint some, right? So moving back to our Viper wallet. All right, so now we can see the newly generated token here, right? We can see the circulating supply at zero, the remaining supply is 10 million, which basically is our token cap, right? Let me jump in and mint some tokens. Right, so let's say I want to mint 1 million tokens, right? And I want to use, you know, one of my Viper addresses, and I will send those minted tokens to my own Viper address. All right, so let's mint, right? We have the transaction hash. Let's jump back to our Explorer, and we can see that this transaction is ongoing, right? But we also can, for example, just look it up based on the transaction hash. And here are our transaction details, and you can see that the trust score is rising because there are different transactions that are going on chain and basically are attached to DAG. They're pushing our transaction forward. And when it reached the required trust score, the transaction is now confirmed. So additional things that we added is, for example, right, so this transaction originated from this address to my address, and I want to see what is happening with this address, right? So I can see now that I have a single token on this address, right? I have a million CODIs on this address, and I have an additional one token, and here's my tokens list. Additional things that we added are the token screen, right? So here you can see all the tokens that were generated in this development environment. If you saw in our previous videos, you're aware that there's the SBG token that Chakhov generated and minted. So let's see what we have here. So I deep dive into the token itself. I can see there's a description space, right? So let's assume that we will onboard enterprises. We'll be able to provide a description about this token. Here we have some token properties, the name, the symbol, the hash, the issuer hash, which is really important in order to understand who issued this token. The generation time, the max supply, circulating supply, and scale. And what is great that we can see all the transactions that happened related to this token, right? So if I'll go back to home, let's say I want to see transactions that's happening with the LSBG token, right? So I click and I can see the latest transactions done with the LSBG token. So for each transaction, I can go to the to address, to the from address, and basically get, okay, so I just jumped to an address details view, right? And we have the address hash, we have the balance, and on this particular address, we can see that we have five different tokens on balance, and we can see all the transactions related to this particular address. Also, we have the transactions screen, which basically you can see all the latest transactions with the ability to go back and see all the latest transactions. I believe it's up to 200 transactions now. Let's talk about the search options, right? So I can use the search, for example, to search for an address, right? So that's one option. You can see an address. I can also look up token by token name or symbol. So let's say I'm looking for, we had LLL, right? So I can see I have green with the symbol LLLL, and this is basically the token hash. So the search is really flexible. I can look up transaction hashes, addresses, particular tokens. So this is a significant improvement over the previous Explorer that we had, and we are really excited to release it, and we think it will make our users' lives much easier. It will help our support, and in the future it will help the enterprises that are going to use our trust chain. Everything is transparent, accessible, and super easy to use. And of course, in addition, we added mobile web support. Basically, the UI itself is dynamic, right? So if you use it on a tablet, you will see it in a certain view. If you use it on a smaller device, such as a mobile phone, you will see a different layout, and it's really user friendly. So we will be happy to receive your feedback and comments on this new Explorer 2.0. So thank you for watching this video, and stay COTI.